This is the Atlantic coast of the British Isles. It's renowned as one of the most dangerous and hostile coastlines in the world. And yet, for millennia, people have come to live and work here. Following in their wake is columnist and author Adam Nicholson. With three islands in Scotland, five children, and over 200 pigs, sheep, and cows to look after, he's a busy man. But last summer, he remortgaged his house to buy the Ork, and with skipper George Fairhurst is going to take on this beautiful and blasted shore to find out who lives here and discover how the power of the Atlantic shapes their lives. Along the way, he also hopes to learn how to sail. Adam has arrived at Britain's newest monastery, Golgotha, a converted farm on the small island of Papa Stronsay in the Orkneys. 25 monks from all over the world, calling themselves the Transalpine Redemptorists, have come here to escape the rigors and temptations of modern life. They're attempting to recreate the same ascetic ideals that inspired the early Christian desert fathers. Their guiding light is Vicar General Michael Mary.
Adam, most welcome.
Oh, very nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. This is Father Anthony.
Hello.
Hello, I'm Adam.
Good to meet you, Father Anthony.
Who's this here?
This is Peppy.
Happy, hello.
He's a Newfoundland.
He's huge.
Ready to lick you to death.
He's a bear.
But when did you want to come down to where you're staying tonight?
I'd love to do that.
Let's go.
Okay.
Each monk lives in an identical bungalow cell.
It's a serious development.
They're all named after monastic founders, and Adam has been lent one for the night.
The Desert of St. Francis. What a beautiful name for a night's lodging.
Come on.
It's essentially a heated Tuscan tile desert so far. Not much in the way of possessions.
No.
Are you allowed anything of your own here?
No. It is a totally common life. According to St. Alphonsus, you don't even own the pins in your collar. The idea is, I've sent a gift, for example, when I had my anniversary or my birthday, then I can't use it. If it comes to me, the only thing I know is it's got to go to someone else, and that's a law that's part of religious life.
So you own nothing?
No, and anything that's given to me, I can't keep.
What about socks?
Well, they all come out of a common bag. Socks come out of a common bag.
Shared socks, pants.
If they need someone else needs them, then they'll be given to them.
So what's going to happen tomorrow? What's the program?
Tomorrow is a rise at 3:15 for Mass at 3:45.
All right, early start.
And, yeah. Well, it's very early, but I mean, it's good for you. You'll enjoy it.
There is one thing I should tell you.
Yes, well, what is it?
Well, I'm not confirmed. Well, I'm not confirmed in any church, and I'm certainly not a Catholic in any way.
Well, it's never too late to do the right thing.
How did I know you were going to say that? Well, I've told them I'm not a Catholic and I don't believe in God. But, well, you know, you've just got to look around here. They're going to have a go, aren't they? They're going to try and get me. You can't have a fish swimming in and out of the net and not try and grab him.
The monks founded their order in 1988 in reaction to what they saw as a dilution of the church's doctrine by the Vatican's introduction of the new Mass in 1969. The only Transalpine Redemptorists in the world, prayers are said in Latin 8 times a day.
God, Jesus
Christ. It's 3:15, and time for the first Mass of the day.
The idea of doing this every morning. God. Really? I'm late. Late.
Non sono tanto, ma non è niente di dolore, sovvero, vai mai.
It's an incredible way to start the day. 3/4 of an hour of Latin and communion every day. It was like being in some kind of spiritual gym. All these well-honed spiritual athletes around me. I was the only guy in yellow and feeling pretty baggy. All I could think of was what sort of car I was going to buy next week. It makes you wonder, what is this for? What are they doing in the middle of the night? And quite awkward not knowing how to be with this. You know, do I kneel? Do I cross myself? Do I sit? I feel rather like a cuckoo. I'm in here, but I'm not off here.
After Mass, no one goes back to bed. There's another 3 hours of mental prayer and communal worship.
There's a purity and beauty about the morning Mass that you can't get, even in a big cathedral, after all the bells have been ringing and the bishop comes in and all vestments and all the splendor you could have. Most of the church has abandoned this Mass. We're talking about 2,000 years of exactly what had been done. Now, when you think about it, we talk about all the different hermits that lived around this area, all around the Scottish Isles. If those hermits came back today, we could not speak to them, but we could pray with them.
We have the same language.
It's 7 a.m., and at last, time for breakfast. Next, there's 4 hours of daily chores until lunch.
And I asked Father Michael Mary why everyone was quiet at breakfast, or why he made everyone be quiet at breakfast, and he said that people needed space for that, which is absolute nonsense. They were longing for a yak, weren't they? You could see it in them. Anyway, on Thursdays, apparently, you were allowed a yak, and you can't get in there for the noise.
100-mile-an-hour winds are not unusual here, and it's often impossible for the monk's boat to get across to Stronsay, so they live as self-sufficient a life as they can. Much of the monastery still needs building, and they're doing most of the work themselves. Adam, however, has been asked to help out at the more agricultural end of the monastery. His next chore is feeding the calves, with Michael Fite, an initiate from Virginia, USA, who arrived 6 weeks ago.
Doris is a thoroughbred Jersey,
yeah.
So she'll be a little more active than the other.
She's frisky.
Oh, she's very frisky.
And do you remember what it was that made you want to be a priest?
My family was homeless, living in Idaho. My little brother had just died, and you know, we were just at this parish. And I looked up, it was a traditional mass, and I saw the priest lift up the host just after the consecration. And right then, I thought, yeah, that's what I want to do. At 5 years old.
How have you found it since you've been here?
I mean, physically, it's hard, but everything you do, feeding the calves, cleaning out the shed, washing dishes, is by definition an act of worship to God. And that earns you merit. And that counts towards your salvation. Whereas in the world, you'd be very hard-pressed to do anything like that. Even if you're a secular priest.
It's a whole life here, is what you're saying. It's a completely
whole package.
Do you think you'll stay?
I hope so, yeah. But it's really not up to me, it's up to God.
Most of the monks' funding comes from private donations, but they have ambitious plans to set up a cheese-making business with the small herd of Jersey cows they keep on the island. But even in the milking shed, there's no escape from the Latin. Brother Yusuf, a Lebanese-Australian and a black belt in karate, has found the cows give better milk when he sings.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae,
It was hard not to fall under the spell of the self-assurance that everyone in the monastery seemed to radiate. And the longer I spent with them, the less certain I became of my own godless woolliness.
Do you believe in objective right and wrong?
Well, if you believe in objective right, you believe in a God.
Exactly. You believe in God?
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
No, I'm not entirely sure. To the extent that I take a position, it is a position of doubt.
Doubt. So you put yourself
and
in
a doubt. And a condition of, yes, remaining in a condition of unresolved doubt.
Which is very convenient, but look at all these things that need not have been. You need not have existed, I need not have existed, and yet we do exist. Therefore, we must go back to something which is necessary, whose existence is necessary, and that is God.
They're having a go. They're trying to get me. You know, I've had some pretty heavy, rather philosophical, rational conversations which leave me completely at sea. You know, I try and wheel out my arguments, and I realise my whole head is just a calendar. It's just a pack it in and it just pours at the ends.
It's 12:30, and if Adam was hoping for a chance to collect his thoughts at lunch, he finds no respite.
The Epistle of St. Paul, the Apostle to the Corinthians, chapter 11. There is not the least doubt that the sign of the cross, made with faith and piety, has the power to banish devils and to work miracles. The writings of the fathers of the church...
It just feels very odd, a room full of whatever it is, 25 men, all on the same jag. You know, they're all on the same line. No communication, though, no kind of eye contact between any of them. They're isolated people. But I'm getting better. I'm more into it. I feel much more monastic this afternoon than I did this morning at 3 o'clock.
After lunch, there's an unusual break from the routine of daily chores. Across the water on Stronsay, it's the annual local raft race, and the monks who were pipped at the post last year are out to exact revenge. With competition stiffer than ever, they've asked Adam, the experienced seaman, to be their cox.
Past that fog boy, turn to the right.
To the next boy?
To the next boy, which is near the pier.
Yeah.
And then we make our way back on the other side of this third boy, and then back here.
Back here, fine. That's straight up.
I'm pushing. Go. In. Jump in now.
The monks get off to a slow start and are led comprehensively to the first corner by the Aussie rulers.
Hard on the right! Hard on the right!
But by the time they round the second boy, superior manpower, not to mention the will of God, has put them in front.
Keep it strong! Long and strong! Long and strong! Long!
And it's an easy run in for their inaugural victory.
Papa Stronsay!
It's amazing to arrive here at the edge of the world and find a community of people driving along their path with such spirit. Every bit of life that we've seen on the whole of the Atlantic seaboard has been either fading or marginal or over. And this seems to be right at the beginning of something. I'm not sure I believe in God, but I'm very drawn by the conviction of the people here and incredibly impressed by the discipline and rigour of what's happening here.
Before Adam leaves, he goes to say goodbye to Father Michael Mary. It's been a theologically challenging 24 hours, and it's not over yet.
Is passing, and you've got a soul, and that will not pass. And after this life, what's going to happen? You've got to go one way or the other.
I will die, I will be gone, and I'll be lost.
To go to the pit, for you mean to hell?
Why not?
No, don't say such a thing.
What would it be like for me?
It'd be too terrible to even think about.
I don't think of it as hell. I think of it as nothing. An absence.
But that won't change. Just as we can say, well, this desk here, let's make out it's a marshmallow. You won't be able to eat it. Let's make out it's not there. If you walk into it, you'll hurt yourself. Spiritual things are as real as material things. And denying them won't make them disappear.
Adjutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Father Michael and most of the monks accompany Adam back to George and the waiting orc on Stronsay for a last service and blessing.
Many thanks. A blessed boat. What is that? Oh my goodness, a rosary. Oh my goodness me. Are you giving this to me? That is astonishing. Thank you so much. You've given us so much. And this is to crown it all. How wonderful. Thank you.
Very good. Thank you.
Yeah, and I feel unworthy.
Good. Good on you, all of this.
Very good. Thank you all.
Thank you all.
I'm deeply touched. I don't know why it touches us so much.
Just reduce it. Do want you to be bored. The harbour of salvation.
I know.
Port of heaven.
I know.
Port of Tony. Keep your eyes on the Stella Maris.
Yeah, the harbour of salvation. Wow.
That's further than Kirkwall today.
It's beyond words. I think you can see it's beyond words. Oh, no!